In the market system as a whole, the prices direct the materials automatically to the best uses to benefit the consumers. This is called allocation. We can use a different color to show that if there is a shortage of something, then the prices will go up. It costs more money from raw materials to consumers. If a cheaper material can be substituted, that can bring the prices down. And the firms still costing more must adjust or lose business. Automatic allocation and substitution are an important major capability of the market system. On the group side, there are many things. For example, a group of friends, a business firm, a cell phone system, a city with suburbs, a nation, an insurance pool, and an individual person surrounded by work inputs. We may think of these as very different, but they all work to reduce costs and risks, which might lead to growth. Let's demonstrate briefly. A new group of friends start to relate to each other and develop fairness and trust, and this helps them to make larger and quicker exchanges. If we put their sharing at the original size, we see that there is a surplus gain, which may be collected maybe to have a celebration, or else remain distributed. Inside a business firm, the entrepreneur directs the workers to transform the material into a product, and then redirects them to do it better and quicker, to increase production and revenue. A city with suburbs such as Philadelphia, which is really shaped like this, historically provided nearby employment and goods to the suburbs. Here we show the traveling people as flows too. This helped the suburbs grow into more commerce and travel between themselves. A cell phone system makes communication quicker and easier. A conversation between two people is really going through the center firm, although it seems like it is just between them. Adding software can make it a platform to find knowledge, do business, play games, and be entertained. A nation has many levels, and people are elected to the government to make laws and to reduce cost, risk, and uncertainty by public safety and external defense, by infrastructure, by social programs, and by environmental protection, allowing many kinds of growth at all the levels. Health insurance is a pool of money paid in premiums or taxes, which covers the larger cost of medical treatment when you are ill or hurt and need help, with the aim to keep everybody healthy, learning, growing, creating, producing, trading, and relating with everybody else in many other ways. And an individual person has his or her own group of many work inputs and tries to reduce work costs by proximity or bringing the work closer by improving skill and by invention of new technology, all to get more in return. These are very different examples. And, of course, there are many more, with many different centers and purposes. The social sciences sort them into loose categories with separate descriptions. For example, economists say that institutions reduce transaction costs. But here we can see a formal similarity in all of them, from the different kinds of capital, through social actions, to spatial clusters, which are also called agglomerations. In every case, a single design or constraint, which we are putting at the center, reduces the costs and/or risks, which allows the flows to grow. We can elaborate this further and say that a single design or constraint, which may be an idea, person, organization, technology, or spatial proximity, reduces the costs and/or risks of repeated interactions, which allows the flows to grow in size and/or speed, causing satisfaction and surplus. It is easiest to call this unitary efficiency or focal efficiency because they are single-pointed. But the important thing to remember is that they each may reduce some kinds of costs, which might lead to growth. This doesn't happen necessarily. It is one of the possible efficiencies, like those of the market. Of course, these may need an upgrade, or even become obsolete. This can be true of institutions as well as machines. Indeed, all the kinds of capital fit the description. Take a single person as a center, called human capital. This is also known as you, with your skills and your group of work inputs. As we just saw, you work on different things, and you try to reduce work costs to get a return. But this isn't the only way to reduce costs. If you work on only one thing, or specialize, let's say these are cows, so you are milking cows, you can increase proximity, skill, and invention further to get even better results at the one thing, much more than when having to do the other kinds of work too. So if everyone, instead of trying to work on everything, specializes, then they can increase their own inputs even better. And then after they trade, they all can have more of everything. Look at the levels. The whole group has rules to reduce transaction costs of each trade. While at the individual level, each one tries to reduce work costs. And in between the two cost reductions is another source of growth, called the gains from specialization and trade, because they all can have more of everything. This combination can apply to almost every group we have pictured. For example, in a business firm, the boss will choose the specialists to hire for each step in the process, and then reduce costs among them to make more product and revenue. This is a main source of growth in the market system. Also in the market, the firms specialize to trade with each other, aided by allocation and substitution.